ready to go. I've cleaned everything up. I've just pulled together the things I want a comparison swatch with. And now I've kind of gone blank. What am I doing here? What? I'm doing new makeup. I know that much. And I have three new products. One of the products I have three iterations of, and we're going to put them on the face. This is not first impressions. I did shoot this the other day, and in addition to that, I've worn all of these several days. So they're not brand spanking new, but they're pretty darn new. And we're going to get into it. What are we going to get into? I have got my very first Quint from Guerlain. And this is what she looks like. It's a neutral lover's dream. Even if you're not into neutrals, I feel like, for me personally, once in a while, I need a palette cleanser. This is kind of that. We're going to compare that to my more recent Tom Ford and do some swatches and put some on the face. So Raw Beauty just came out with these concealers in a wand. This is the Dewdrop, and it would go beautifully with the Dewdrop foundation, which I'm wearing today. So we're going to put that on, and we're going to do some comparison swatches so we can see what the color is all about. And then finally, Valentino came out with these lovelies. These are cheeks and eyes. I got three colors, and we're going to put them all on my cheeks. Well, no, we're not going to do the red on the cheeks, but we're going to put all these colors on the lips and two of the colors on the cheeks. Where to start? Since I already have my foundation on, let's go in with the concealer. Let me just get my notes. My glasses are in the other room. So let's make the font huge, and I'm just going to read it on my computer. This Raw Beauty Dewdrop Concealer takes multitasking cues from the best-selling Dewdrop Foundation. Its creamy hydrating formula provides natural-looking, buildable coverage to reduce the appearance of darkness and puffiness. Hard-working skincare ingredients like retinol, hyaluronic acid, and vitamin C help your delicate under-eye area retain moisture, soften fine lines, and improve skin's texture. Dab with sponge applicator. Yes, there's a sponge applicator. Formulated with retinol to help soften fine lines, hyaluronic acid adds moisture to the delicate under-eye area. Vitamin C helps improve skin's texture. Combination of green tea extract and caffeine help reduce puffiness. Caffeine does reduce puffiness. Niacinamide fights discoloration, available in 10 versatile shades. I got the shade 3 and 4. The foundation is in shade 4. And because it's so sheer, I think it works right now. But I do think it's hair too light for me right now. So this is what they look like. This is the 3. And this is the 4, which seems like a pretty good shade for me right now. This too light. I'm going to do a little bit of comparison swatches, just a few things so you can get an idea. The Tom Ford. Here's the Tom Ford in creme. And golly, it's a lot like the number 4. The Givenchy right here, and this is N250. Again, in that zone of the number 3. And the Dior. And the Dior is 2N. And this is why I don't use the Dior very often. It's much more yellow to me, and even too light. It just doesn't sit there. So this one I use when I'm wearing something that's super yellow. It is a lovely product, but the color, not so much for me. There is a sponge applicator, as you can see. The word of advice, when you first get them, do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and wait. And then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then wait. You might be there for a little while, but if you just go ham, boop, 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 it's going to be an explosion, and you're going to lose a lot of product that you wish was on your face. I love this sponge because, unlike the Charlotte Tilbury sponge, this fits right here on me. And I have darkness right there. The Angie Hot and Flashy, you can use a sponge, you can use your fingers. Sometimes feel that this is a little bit faster. Stretch out the eye and look up. This looks so beautiful under the eye. Look at that. It looks like skin. It doesn't look cakey. You know, recently I did a review on the Natasha Denona, and I just felt that it's probably better for people who don't have so many little lines, big wrinkles, troughs, all that. If you're, you know, up to 45 maybe, or 50, that might be beautiful on you. But on me, I felt like it was such a little bit fussy. And now I'm going to put a little bit on my cheeks. I'm kind of like going to get rid of any color. A little bit more on the nose. And that lighter color, I could absolutely do a little bit of highlighting. I mean, since I have it, this might work for me in the winter months, but I'm not sure. But I'll do a little bit of here, a little highlighting. The teeniest bit, you guys, this goes a long way when I use it on my face for highlighting. I'm using a very soft hand with the blend, but I'm still blending nicely. Okay, gonna scooch in a little bit. I feel like I put more on this side than on this side. This coverage on this side, better, right, than on this side. So you can build your coverage. Let's give it a try. I mean, in theory, that's telling me you can build coverage. I just feel like once you put it on building concealer, fussy. I'd rather get it right the first time. There we go. So I feel like you have good coverage, looks like skin, and I have to tell you, I have used this 3, 4, 5 times. It wears very nicely all day long. It doesn't crease, and it doesn't look dehydrating, which is an issue under the eyes when you get a little bit older. The teeniest bit of powder, and voila. Now, for eyeshadow, I think I'm going to disappoint you a little bit. Like I said, I did shoot this the other day, and one of the reasons I didn't like it was I felt that the eyes were too dark for everything else that was going on, especially when I put on the red lip. It looked a little too evening. But I do want to compare to the Tom Ford, because I bought that recently, and I think initially I was thinking, and you may be thinking as well, why do I need this one if I have this one? But hopefully you can see the color story is slightly different. I'm going to swatch these two, the two pinks, so you can see what it is. It could make all the difference if you have a warmer undertone than I do. So this is Tom Ford, and this is the Galant. It looks peachy, even though in the pan it looks pinky. So the Galant runs a little bit warmer. And I'm going to take this. Now this is a shimmer shade, where in the Galant it is a matte. Tom Ford, Galant. When I put my hand like this, I can see they're very similar in shades, but there's still a little pinky nature in it, even though the reflect is more peach. So I feel like they're different enough. This shade in the Galant looks like it's brown, but when I swatched it on my hand, I felt like it's more in the taupe zone, which I love. See, it's the reflect that makes it look a little bit taupe. And what a beautiful swatch that was. Really lovely. Now I'm inclined, you guys, to make it very, very, very simple, because this look can get a little bit dark on me, and I'm going on with this pinker color. So it's a pink with a warmness, because it's going to go better with the lip products. And I'm just going to use it as my transition initially. And it blends so beautifully. I would say it's on par with the Tom Fords, which also are beautiful blenders. I've never tried a Galant eyeshadow before, and I don't know what took me so long. I think largely because I don't see other people talking about them, so I figured, well, they must not be good. Not true. It's just that as creators, we are kind of obligated, if we want to be successful, to do videos on products that we think people will be interested in. And I certainly am not very good at doing that, because I oftentimes don't do things that people will be interested in, but I'm not interested in. And sometimes I do things I'm interested in and nobody else is. And I suppose that's why we don't see much going on with this brand, certainly with their quads, but it's a blendable dream. Now, normally, I think this would be enough. I could just do mascara, liner, brows, because of the lip colors that we're going to be doing, but I need to show you a little bit of something. So I'm going to do this with my finger, which, by the way, not too many eyeshadows. Powders with fingers, not so much. But this, it's just such a beautiful formula. And I'm just gonna blend it a little bit. But I just don't want to go too dark today. I just want to try one little thing. I'm perfectly fine with this, but I was just curious. Maybe I'll take a small little brush and go in with this darker color, which is matte, and put it by the lash line. There. Makes a little bit of a difference. I think if I got my brush wet, it would have more of a liner look, but without the hardness of a liner, and I really like that by the lash line. By the way, recently I did the Rare Beauty Eyeliner and Eyebrow Pencil, and I didn't really like either of them, and I thought I would grab this one. And I am reminded why I like this so much. It transfers onto the skin like that, and it's a much, much better color. But I filled out my brows and put on some mascara. I did the brown mascara from Charlotte Tilbury because I want to soften everything up a little bit. And let's talk about these. We're going to do lips, and we're going to do cheeks. And one thing I really want to help you with is the colors, because online, some of these look different. This one looked kind of brown and deep and gorgeous. This is the lightest one, and I'll have the color right down here. This is what it looks like swatched. That's lovely. The second lightest, or the mid-tone, and the red right there. So these are the colors that I got. Let's put them on. My lips actually look this color when I first wake up, where the blood isn't really flowing, and that might be a look from time to time that I want to have. I want to show you this applicator. It reminds me very much of a liquid lip that YSL did. I think it's still out, that gives you so much control that you don't need to do any lining. This is scented, and it's not like vanilla, it's kind of like perfume. I don't know, it could be fruity. Oh, I forgot to take off my gloss, so it's not going to show up matte. Now, they say that you can put a little bit on and just have a stain, and I find, just like this new release from Charlotte Tilbury, they said you can put it on opaque, put it on lightly, the whole bit. Here's a trick about the scent. I don't want any of this inside my lip at all. And now I won't get that taste in my mouth. It's, for me, it's something. I don't know why. Maybe I'm the only person, when I put on something that's scented on my lips, it gets in my mouth. I think this color is actually very sweet, but it makes me a little bit washed out, so I'm going in with this Natasha Denona. Much, much better for my comfort zone. Now we're going to put it on the cheek. Oftentimes with this kind of product, I'm going to put it on my hand and pick it up with a brush, my finger maybe, or with a beauty blender. But with this, I don't have to. It's so much easier than the Rare Beauties. I'm just going to put a little bit on. And the other day when I put this on, something happened that I needed to address somewhere else on my face immediately. So this was on my face probably for 30 seconds or a minute, and it didn't stain. Again, when it comes to cream liquids, I find you got to put them on one cheek at a time or you're going to have trouble. But I do not find that to be the case with this formula. Blends like a flipping dream, and I love this color. Such a very, very pretty, fresh, soft color. And I'm kind of into, if you've been here before, if you've been here recently, you know that I've been going through something in the last 4 or 5 months where I want to have some softer blushes, nude blushes in maybe peach and this and that and the other thing. This is perfect for that. And I wanted to compare it to this. This is from Clé de Peau. I love this color so much. And I was thinking last night, I wonder if they compare. So this is the Clé de Peau, and this is the Valentino. It makes the Valentino look much more pink. And this color is called Perfect Peach, but I don't find it to be incredibly warm. It's just a stunning, stunning color. And I was also wondering about this makeup by Mario, Barely There or Barely Blushed. And that's right here. Just to give you an idea of how these colors compare to each other. Now, you might be asking, how do these feel like? This one feels more moussey than this one, but this one also does feel moussey. It's not like a liquid lip like the Fenty or like the Huda or like the NARS, those very thin liquid lips, which I actually really like. This one is kind of like a moussey matte, but a combination, a baby, the offspring of a typical moussey matte and something very thin and liquidy. It doesn't really feel like much on the lips, but it has a nice kind of cushy slip to it when you rub your lips together. In my experience, this is not long wearing, and I don't remember if they say on the site that it is, but on the lips, it is not. But it's still a really pretty look, and I do like matte lips. So first I'm just going to dab the second color on. And again, you can do this on the teeth if you want to. You can do this with an eyeshadow brush. Where's that eyeshadow brush? Not that I needed to, but I just want to get that color towards the top of the lip. Just a wash of color. Super pretty. Now, let's go on more opaque. I would call this a rosewood shade. I think they're calling it a mauve. Now, let's put some on the cheeks. I'm going to do the darker color a little higher up, and that might be too much, but it's really easy to recover if I put too much. Oh yeah. There we go. And I'm just wiping my finger on a paper towel here. So you can pat, and you can do a little bit of a pull. And now I'm using the full first third of my finger to help take off the excess and continue to blend it. It's really just so easy to work with. Boom. It's kind of mistake proof. If you put on too much, you can remove it without having a stain left. I'm very, very impressed with this as a blush. Now we're going to do the red. I'm not going to put the red on my cheeks, although I do believe I can 100% make that work, not with this eye. Now I'm going to do the same thing, just a dot. Again, a little brush to move the color around a little bit. That you could do an ombre very easily with this. And I really like it with this application where it's just a little bit of a stain. I mean, it's still very, very impactful, but when you look close up to the lips, it doesn't look like a ton of lipstick. Now I'm going to go a little bit more opaque and use a side. You could go in with, for instance, one of these reffers. You could do right around the lip to give it a very sharp lip, but I really enjoy this kind of blotted lip. And it's a beautiful, beautiful color. And that is three new things that I got. So first of all, this concealer from Surratt. You know I love this brand. I really love this concealer. I am going to pull you in. This eye's looking better than this eye. Check out how nice this looks. Just the teeniest, teeniest bit of powder, and I'm not getting any troughing. Well, that's not true. I'm getting the teeniest bit of troughing, which is very common for me. Now just blend it away. I haven't lost any coverage, and I'm not going to have the problem again all day long. And that's pretty typical for actually all of my concealers. There's usually a problem while I'm still in my chair, and then I tap them out and I'm good to go. I think it looks beautiful on the skin. I think the coverage is very good, but it's light, unlike the Natasha Denona that had a heavy nature to it. I have blended this in with my fingers. I blended it in with a brush. I haven't tried it with a beauty blender yet, but there's no doubt in my mind that it will work beautifully with a beauty blender as well. So for me, thumbs up. This Guerlain Quad, I feel that if you are lighter than me, it's possible it might be too dark for you, except for these two shades. If you are darker than me and you have a warmer undertone, this will be a skin-like neutral eyeshadow palette for you. For me, I feel that it runs a little bit warm, even this one, the pink one, but I'm okay with that. I've been using the Tom Ford since I got it almost every day. I'm in a hurry. I just want a little something. Those are the colors that I go to. Those. But for this, I think I'm going to be using it a lot, especially, you know, in these warmer months. I think this is incredibly blendable. You saw I did this with my finger, a powder with the finger. That's crazy. I'm definitely going to be looking at more from this brand in the eyeshadow department for sure. All right, now let's talk about the Valentino. I love these. And, you know, I have kind of a back and forth because they are perfumed and I do get them in my mouth, which I can't stand. But once I did the finger thing the other day, I'm like, okay, now I can make these work because I also love them on the lips. Not long wearing, but they're not drying. They don't pucker my lips up. I love that I can get that sheer, blurry kind of lip. But I like that I can go more opaque as well. I just love these. They're easy to work with on the cheeks. I'm so surprised. It's just the perfume. Really, really bugs me, but I found a workaround. And you guys, those are my new things. And that's it. I'm wrapping it up. Thank you so much for spending some time with me. I hope I helped you making your buying decisions. Everything will be linked down below. And FTC says I have to let you know, but I think you already do know, I can, but not always do, make a small commission if you hit the link and purchase something. Sometimes it doesn't work out that way, and I don't really know why. But yes, there you go. Same with everybody else who links anything at all. And that's it, you guys. Until we meet again, be safe and smart. And I'm wishing you good health.